protecting our external border will be a very important part. Being more efficient on returns will be a very important part. And to find a way of mandatory solidarity mechanism that could be accepted by all member states will also be important, so that we can help those countries of first entry in a meaningful way.
As a Danish minister?
Well, my task is to find a new pact on migration and asylum, and that's why I'm reaching out to all the member states to have a dialogue, and me and Matthias, who had a very good dialogue today, and I think that we understand each other's positions, and I think that there is a good sign of many member states, including Denmark, that are ready to take steps forward for a pragmatic solution.
The Danish idea is to create camps in northern Africa, where you place the asylum seekers so they don't come into Europe even if they apply for asylum. What do you think about that idea?
I don't think it's a realistic idea. I think we need to come forward now. We need to manage migration. We need to be in control of migration. And that's why, and it's urgent, we need a new pact that can be accepted by all the member states and that can take steps forward. And I think that's why I don't think it's realistic to find with these kind of proposals today.
Ylva Johansson, the Danish plan you think is unrealistic, but what are your plans to change the system that you all agree on doesn't work as it should?
My plan is to be very pragmatic and to listen to all the member states. The previous commission presented proposals created in Brussels that has not been able to be adopted by the council. Member states have blocked this. So my approach is to be realistic, to listen to member states, to find a compromise that can be accepted by all the member states. And I think that's why I'm going to have these dialogues that I have today and also with all member states. And of course, I can't answer before I had all these dialogues, but I guess that protecting our external border will be a very important part. Being more efficient on returns will be a very important part. And to find a way of mandatory solidarity mechanism that could be accepted by all member states will also be important, so that we can help those countries of first entry in a meaningful way.
Has the Danish minister convinced you just a little bit? Do you find it a little more realistic, his plans, after this meeting?
I don't think that there's a lot of legal and practical question marks of having these kind of centres outside the European Union. So I think this is not what we should focus on right now. What we should focus on now is to find a new pact that can fly, that can be accepted by all member states, that can protect our borders, that can show that we can manage migration, be in control of migration, and make a distinction between those that are eligible for international protection and those that are not, and those should return. And I think this is absolutely doable, and this is what I focus on. But I really appreciate that the Danish government now is restarting the resettlement program. I think resettlement is a very important part of a way forward for the European migration policies.
Yeah. It sounds like even agreeing upon a new system can take years and years.
We don't have that time. We don't have that time at all. It's urgent, really urgent.
So do you have a timeline for how...
I have a timeline, but I also said I will have a dialogue with all member states. So I think it's not wise of me to set up a very sharp timeline before I have listened to all the member states and have a dialogue with them.
Do you have a timeline for the dialogue with the member states?
Yes, I hope to finish this before the end of January.
January. Okay.
Thank you.